Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of our modded Minecraft series. How you doing? I am very happy right now, guys. Oh, there goes one of my ears. Something has happened. I quite possibly have created the most stupidly overcomplicated thing ever made in modded Minecraft. I'm talking like so stupid. Of course, I'm talking about the coke ovens over here. I think I finally got them working, and I can't wait to show them to you here. We're going to do a demonstration first, and then I'll try to show you quickly how they work. All right. The little details to all the mechanisms and that kind of stuff. Very first thing, like, we started this project a long time ago, and I've been dreading getting this thing going, and I've spent like another 8 hours on it, like, since what we had before. So total, we're looking at over 24 hours on this project, and I'm probably being lowballing it right now, to be honest. But yeah, last episode we started setting up these train system things, right? We need charcoal or coal or some kind of fuel for the trains. Decided to go with charcoal, and in order to turn wood into charcoal, the best method seems to be the coke oven. Because all these other methods, like a furnace, you have to put in energy to make the charcoal. With a coke oven, though, all you gotta do is put the wood in, and it automatically makes charcoal. No extra energy required. And it even gives you creosote oil, a quarter bucket each piece, which we need to make rails, and we also need it to make this treated wood stuff we've been using. So we definitely need to get these coke ovens up and running so we can get more creosote oil and that kind of stuff. So I decided it's time to finish up the coke ovens. And the only downside is these take 900 ticks. Yeah, 900 ticks each piece, which is like 45 seconds. And these get made into charcoal blocks. 9 of them makes a charcoal block. And then each of these ovens holds 15. So we're looking at several hours per load that gets made here. You can see I got some wood in here right now. It's making charcoal very slowly. First thing to show you, let's actually get to the demonstration. So decide to make it semi-automatic. We have a little control panel here. If the light is off, like coke oven 1 here, and I press it, nothing happens. It's got a safety mechanism to stop it from running when it's not ready. In order to get this ready, it needs enough charcoal in here. We'll just speed it along here. We'll put in 15 is the number required to get it going. And hopefully we don't have any mess ups. Hey, you. Oh, lag. All right. Did that work? Yeah, you see, so from the block placer here, it had those charcoal blocks in. Those got placed into the oven. Maybe I'll just open it manually here to show you. So it puts it three rows like this, five in each row, 15 total. All right, now the light turned on because it's done cooking up its load. We press a button. Oh, man. It's my first time hearing it with headphones on. That's a lot louder than it was before. Sorry about that. So it sounds the alarm. Things are going crazy. It starts moving our mechanical arm here. The whole goal of this was to try mimic a real-life coke oven. And I think we got pretty close with it here. So it's going to move into position to coke oven 1. And then we got these little electrode thingies, which control the pistons on this thing. Once it gets into position here, then the oven starts filling up with natural gas. It's to make this cool fire effect when the door opens. So I think that runs for 10 seconds or something. Might be able to shorten it. Oh, and another alarm. All right, doors open up. And you get the fire effect. Starts pushing the arm out, extending. Let's go to the other side here. So we can see this happening. The charcoal blocks do not burn. I tested it. So that's pretty cool. And pushes it over the side here. Block breakers break the charcoal blocks. Arm moves them over the side. Starts retracting when it gets to the end. Also have to be very careful I don't use the block breakers on that piston arm. If I did, no more piston arm. So had to control that pretty carefully. We don't have a delivery system and a pickup system set up though for this thing. So we need to set up a train or something to move this hopper minecart after it does that to pick up these charcoal blocks. Something is following me, man. And yeah, they go into the hopper here. I'm telling you guys, Thomcraft has been mean to me lately. We might need to look into dealing with these effects, because... Oh, yeah, and then the door closes when that gets back into position. And the chimneys! We got chimneys on each of these things, which I really like. Those turn off when the doors open, and then they make the smoke particles when the door closes again, when it's cooking up the stuff. So, how does it all work here? Well, we'll try to cover it quickly. Won't get super detailed, but we'll look at the basic idea behind it. Maybe I'll open up the door first and show you. So inside the coke ovens, we have 15 of these block placers. These are what place the charcoal blocks. Each block placer only holds one charcoal block at a time, and they just get placed into the oven. We used to use drawbridges to do this, but I was having issues with them crashing my game, because they don't like it when you remove the blocks. They expect to get them back. So had to switch to these instead. Let's go around the back here. All right, so the coke ovens, they turn the wood into charcoal. Takes 900 ticks, about 45 seconds. Each piece of charcoal it cooks goes into this auto workbench. Once it gets 9 in here, it makes a block. And then those blocks start funneling into this dropper. And I have a precise amount of other blocks in here, so using a comparator here, we detect when 15 charcoal blocks go into here. We don't want any less, and we don't want any more. Exactly 15. It takes, like, I don't know, I didn't do the math, but I'm sure it's at least 3 hours or something, though, before we get 15 charcoal blocks in here. So it's a very long process. Once we do, though, this redstone signal goes to the second dust tier, which activates this repeater. Once that repeater gets activated, then this wire gets triggered. And also, there's an... Oh, we might not be able to look at this. Uh-oh. There's a servo here. Yeah, we got to it. Okay. With charcoal blocks listed only, so it doesn't take the wood out of the dropper, just the charcoal blocks. And then those go up into here, the transfer node. Oh, the poor guy. His life was so short. Put this back. And then this puts it into these hyper-rationing pipes from extra utilities, I believe. These only allow one item to go into an inventory, no more than one. So it spreads them out evenly, which is nice. One per block placer. And after a certain amount of time... you got like a long delay repeater here that then sends a signal to all these block placers, which makes them place the charcoal blocks. Maybe we can see this happening again. Did I bring them with me? Oh, maybe they're in the hopper. Come back here, charcoal blocks. Very, very precious material here. Don't want to lose these. All right. Yeah. So put 15 in here. 1, 2, 3. So it goes out. Oh, hey, no. Oh, my goodness. Give me a heart attack, why don't you? you might have saw that servo turned on for a brief moment, though, and you just heard the blocks get placed. You see how this wire is lit right now? Once the repeater shuts off here, that'll shut off. And inside the coke oven, those charcoal blocks are placed. This all happens while the door is closed, though. All right, and you'll notice this chimney here is affected by redstone wire, so it turns on and off depending on if this is lit or not. You know, maybe I can't show you everything here. This is going to take too long, but there's a wire here that tells our light over here to turn on as well. There's an RS NOR safety latch system here. Ah, it's a bad place, I tell you. Anyways, the whole thing is controlled by this computer here. I'll show you the program quickly if I can. Just skim through it. Coke oven. All right, I'm just going to scroll through it. You can pause it if you want. This is what controls all these bundled cables, though. So it waits for a redstone signal, and then it makes this stuff here. This is the main loop to the program. All right. And there's a shell command, or a startup program, that makes this run as soon as the chunk loads, so I don't have to turn it on all the time. And, yeah, this cable here goes to these pistons, which control the arm. And then there's more cables here. Those go up to the electrodes. And yada, yada, yada. I guess maybe something that I should focus on is the natural gas thing's pretty cool. Let's grab some of this stuff. So yeah, Glenn's gases isn't really easy to automate, but what we have going on here, we have a Glenn's gases tank with pumps, right? When we unpower these pumps, it pumps the gas into the chambers. This tank, though, wouldn't last very long as it is right now. So in order to fill it, we can actually fill up this cache here. Then the autonomous activator here pumps the gas into the tank. It's filling up right now. And all the empty bottles get filtered up here. So we can have a big storage cache of natural gas without having to refill it constantly, which is pretty cool. And anyways, I'm going to ramble forever if we keep going on this. So we'll leave it at that. That's our coke oven system now. Should be good to go. All right, guys. So let's talk about Thaumcraft here for a second. I think I found out what we need. So every like 5 minutes, I get one of these purple messages, like something is following you, or you've been weakened, or every now and then I'll pee this purple substance on the ground and I got to clean it up. And the one that really annoys me, though, like more than anything, is unnatural hunger. It drains all my food. I don't know what that was. Drains all my food, and then I gotta, like, go get more food. Like, constantly. This keeps happening. It's really annoying. It's happening because I've unlocked all the research. Some of these that have the purple aura thing around, it's forbidden knowledge, and that gives you what's called permanent warp. Warp makes bad things happen. So there's no turning back now. I have too much warp, and bad things are happening. So to deal with it, there seems to be... Oh, I lost it now, guys. Was it here? No, man, I totally lost it. Here it is. Purifying bath salts. I think this is what we need. It says, warp is a danger for even the most careful of thaumaturgs. For those that have done a bit too much dabbling, warp effects are probably more than just an annoyance. Oh, they are really annoying. Purifying bath salts help with that. Simply tossing these salts into water will turn the water into a silvery, purifying liquid that soothes away the stresses of the day and brings temporary relief from the effects of warp. Okay. So we need these. And then there's a spa that like automatically applies the bath salts, I'm pretty sure. So biggest problem with this is we need this aura stuff. And I have a hard time finding that. Order is easy to get. You can get that from Chiseled Bricks. I think you can get the brain one here from Books. Sano? I'm not sure. Let's check out. Oh. Uh-oh. Oh, I thought the game crashed. What happened there? All right, whatever you want, you can check your book here. And everything you've scanned, it'll tell you what has that. So, Sano. I've scanned nothing that has it. Uh-oh. I have no idea how to get that then. Like, if we hover over this one, it tells us all the items. This one, apparently I haven't found anything yet. Okay, so I just checked online. It sounds like the only places we can get it, the Sano aspect, is from Cake and from Healing Potions or Regen Potions. So we're going to go with the Cake route here. Cake takes milk, eggs, sugar, wheat. Kind of an annoying thing to make, but thankfully we have an automatic milking room here. We have a wheat field, we have a chicken farm. The only thing we really don't have is an automatic sugar or reed farm. Oh, I don't know what this one does. Oh, we got flux flu now. Great. Oh, and I'm peeing. Good. This is why we got to do this, guys, because it's really annoying. Get rid of this. So yeah, I just hooked up a machine here that should automatically fill up tanks above this autonomous activator now. Let's try it out. Grab a cow. Put him in a pen here. Her in a pen, whatever. Alright. Oh, frame rate. What happened to the frame rate? Okay, so... yeah, milk buckets should enter here. Then they right-click into the tank. Oh, is it picking up the milk afterwards? You see how it's going up and then down? Oh, that stinks. So it's ejecting the milk, but then it's picking up right away, too. Like, every time, I think. It looks like it's empty when it leaves, though, every time. Oh, no, I think it is going up. Yeah, I think that tank is pretty much full now. Okay, good, it works. It's time for another episode of Cooking with Etho! Alright guys, so this is how you bake a cake. Start off with a cubic meter of homogenized, hormone-fed, delicious, irradiated milk. Alright. Mass-produced, of course. And take three buckets, fill them up with that wonderful milk. And with our AE system, it's going to give it that non-human touch that we crave with our food. Basically, I think we're going to go for this recipe. Natura? Is that how you say it? Natura seems to have cheapened the recipe here. Can you convert it to flour, then we only need one instead of three. Oh, it's getting bad, guys. It's getting really bad. Then what we can do is it gonna let us make a recipe of it here? Let's try it out. Okay, yeah, we can do it. So make a recipe. We put that in our fluid assembler. This is for making any recipe involving fluids. Normally it's a real pain, but this allows us to do it pretty quickly. And then give our AE system tons of milk with our fluid terminal. Alright, so I added 29 buckets. And there should be a cake recipe here now, right? Yeah. Okay, give it some eggs, sugar. Let's break down the rest of this wheat. Give it to it as well. And we should be able to mass produce cakes this way. Because we're probably going to need a lot of soap, it turns out. Baking cakes to make soap. This is a very weird game, isn't it, guys? Okay, does it work? Yeah, it's working. Aha! And I have one more food source now. Awesome. Let's see, do I have my Thumbcraft scanner? Let's just make sure this is actually what we need. Nope. There it is, found it. Okay, throw a cake on the ground. So it gives us four? Why does it give you metal? Cake gives you metal? It must be that delicious frosting. Okay, interesting. Why would it give you metal? Man, you can abuse that so badly. Like, I can make metal, tin, iron, anything I want from this then. That's kind of crazy. Oh, because of the buckets, maybe? Oh, I bet you it thinks there's buckets in the recipe. Even though you get them back, normally. That's very weird. Okay, guys, so I got this stuff together here for the Arcane Spa. We're going to relax today. It's going to be wonderful. I don't know. I think we only need one. I'm just going to make one for now. And our cakes are being broken down as we speak. The red color there is what we want. That's the Sano aspect. It's being crystallized, and we're going to be able to make the soap out of that. Yeah, right here. We got 23, 24. Good. And this is my go-to method, guys, whenever we want to automate something in Thumbcraft. Like, we need the salt stuff and then four aspects. So what we're going to do is get the crucible, these alchemical constructs. Then you got to tap it with your wands. Ta-da! And then I just do this arrangement like this. with the furnaces. These are alchemical furnaces. They break down matter into different aspects. I just put one alembic on top. And then the piping. I think we can just do this, actually. Right? Hopefully. We'll try it out. And then just put some fuel in these things. Or automatically put fuel in from below. Okay, and gotta have some heat source underneath here, so I'll put some lava down. Oh, where did it go? I had some. There it is. Good. And this is about ready. So, I got the four aspects crystallized now. So, we'll put them in here. And hopefully no mistakes have been made. Because these are very hard to collect. I don't want to lose them. Alright, so that's going in there. That's our Sano. That's our brains. Aura. Order. Good. Then on our machine here, we put this in. And if we want it to start crafting, let's click that. Is it going to get stuck? Seems to have gotten stuck on the brain. Man, I really don't like Thaumcraft pipes. I don't know. Because they're equal distance from each other to the machine here. You would think they'd be able to share. But no. I'm going to connect in the back there and then here. See if that helps. Okay, I got the brain now, but it can't get the order. Man, I thought I've tried this in the past and it worked pretty good. Oh, now it's going. That was our first bath salt. Oh, yes. Okay, so we got our spa here. We got our bath salts. Oh, this is going to be good, guys. This is going to be good. I don't quite understand this. I think it says it fills a 5x5 area above the location where the machine is placed with liquid. I think we have to pump liquid into the spa block, maybe. Oh, what's down here? I don't want to know. I'm just going to fill this in. All right, so maybe we'll put an aqueous accumulator right down there. So we need some water. Let's put water on both sides so it fills up. And over here. Okay, so now this should get water. Good. And then we put a fluid duct over top. Yeah, it's pumping already. Good. Put that into the spa. Oh yeah, this is for water. Okay, good. Mix with ingredients. Use just the fluid. Oh, no. Oh, it's like a pump. Wait, does it fill the full 5x5 with water? Oh, that's kind of an interesting machine, actually. Can't think of anything else that works like that, actually. Alright, but that's not what we want. We want the special liquid with our bath salts. That's just water. That's no good. But I think if we mix with ingredients and put the salts in, let's just do one. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's got bubbles. Oh, this is going to be amazing. Okay, we'll put it all in. I don't know how long they're going to last here, honestly. Oh, but this is nice. Okay, warp ward, 26 minutes and 30 seconds. Does that refresh every time I go in here? Or what's the deal? That's not very long, guys. Like, and we're out. Uh-oh. I don't know what this is going to do, but I'm worried after our warp ward runs out here, like, is it 22 minutes now? If I go in here, it still doesn't refresh. I'm worried this is going to turn back into water after the time is up. And that means we just spent 6 bath salts for like 30 minutes of protection. Not even. That's not a good return on our investment. Those bath salts were not easy to make. So I don't know. Maybe I should just do like a 1x1 thing of water if that's possible. It would probably last a lot longer that way. I think we wasted a bunch here. But yeah, anyways, I'll see what this thing does. It is time to wrap up the episode, though. Unfortunately, I wasted a lot of time on that coke oven, but I'm very happy to get it going. Comment of the day says, you should make a tree farm that you made in your Let's Play so you can get wood and turn it into charcoal for the train. But instead of the gas to break the wood, use item breakers. I do need to make a new tree farm. I don't know if I'm going to use item breakers. Maybe. Or terrain smashers. Yeah, it might be a good idea, actually. The problem with this one, like, this is good. We did the robot thing. But the stupid lumberjack, let me show you. I bet you he's trapped right now. Oh, and this dark axe, very bad for chopping down trees, honestly. Just used up all the power in it. Yeah, here he is. Look at this. So he gets trapped inside the tree when it grows. Then he runs out of power, and that's it. He's stuck forever. So this tree farm is pretty much flawed. I don't think you could ever reliably use these guys. Or if you do, you have to make sure all the trees have grown. Otherwise, they may get trapped. So yeah. Need a new tree farm, for sure. This one is not going to cut it anymore. But we'll think about that again in the next episode. Hope you guys enjoyed today, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.